Hi, in this lecture we'll see how to do the layouts using the grid layout. Okay, so this is the sample code which I have written. So here is the grid container and we have certain elements like item 1, item 2 and item 3 in this particular grid container. Okay, so if I want to align this item 1, item 2 and item 3 in row like one besides another, then what can I do? Okay, so we can the first like we can do the grid layouts in many ways. The first way in which I am going to show is like you think like however you have thought in the flexbox, right? In the similar way you will think here also. Okay, so let's see how it is. So we will give first display grid and then so once you give display grid nothing will happen, but then once you give grid template columns and you just give auto and auto, like for example like three columns, then see everything has been aligned in column wise, like 1 2 3 columns. Okay, so display grid is the grid layout, and the grid layout has two properties. One is grid template columns and grid template rows, just as we had flex direction row and flex direction column. In similar way we have grid template columns and grid template rows, but the advantage here is in the grid template columns we can, for example, say here 80 pixels. So the first element will occupy only the 80 pixel width, and if you give auto, then it will automatically leave equal spacing. In this way, if you are aligning the items, it is no different from the flexbox layout. So this is one way of using the grids. Okay, so then let's move on to the second way of using it. Like for example, if we have to align, let us suppose, the elements in this way. Okay, so how do we do it using grids? Okay, let's see first how we do it using flexbox, right? We first used to define this topmost border in HTML, that container ID we used to define. Then we used to go column wise, how many columns are there, how many rows are there. So according to that, whatever boxes we are seeing, we used to define those. For example, this is one row and this is one row. So these two are the rows which I'm seeing in the topmost. So I used to create these two divs first. Then in the bottom div, I am seeing the left div and this right div. So I create these two. And in the right div, I'm seeing again top div and bottom div. So like that, I used to think in the flexbox. In similar way, I can do using this also, like grid template columns and grid template rows. So using that also, I can do the same thing. Like as I thought in the flexbox, I can think in the same way, and I can use the grid also. But there is a second way of doing things using grids. Okay, so how is that? We'll see that now. Okay, so this is the way you think while doing CSS grids using the second way which I'm going to show. Okay, if we have to achieve this layout, how do we do it in Excel, right? So first we'll give the header because that is the topmost element. This is one column. And the second column, this is also starting at the same place where this header is starting, right? So I'll give menu here. And then besides menu, I am seeing main and right. So I'll give main and right. Then the start of the footer is starting where main is starting. So I'll give the footer here. So I'll give the footer here. So this is the way I align, right? Before doing any merging, this is how it looks like. So if you see now, this is the entire content area, right? So for this entire content area, first thing I need to define is to define the container. So that is what we have done here. So what we have done is we have defined the topmost grid container, right? And I have closed it here, in which all the elements are placed. And what are those elements? Those elements would be like header, menu, main, right, and footer. All these things are placed, are wrapped inside this grid container. Okay, so that is what I have defined, like header, menu, main. So everything, like sorry, this should be right, and this should be footer. So all these things I have defined. So now what we need to do is there is a property called grid templates. Okay, how do we use it is we can say first display flex, sorry, display grid, right? And then we can use this property called grid template. Okay, so grid template, whenever you are thinking in grids, right, especially using these grid templates, you need to think in a two-dimensional way. Like for example, if you see this example, this is the entire content area. And in this content area, you must see how many columns you are occupying. Right, 1, 2, 3. These are the maximum number of columns, and how many rows you are occupying? Right, 1, 2, 3 again. So this is also a maximum number of rows. So you need to first take the maximum number of rows and maximum number of columns. Okay, so then you need to define, like in the first header, like first row, what is the elements you are seeing? Right, you can say header. Header, header, header. Okay, in the first row I am seeing, in the first row there are three columns, and in each column only header element is there. Okay, you can define any name here. I am just giving header, header, header. Okay, so in the second row what I am seeing is menu, and then main, and then right. So what am I seeing in third row? Right, ideally here I am seeing empty. This is empty because we need to get a layout like this, right? So in the third row also, in the first column, in the third row first column also, this menu should come, right? So I'll give menu here. Okay, menu, and then other two columns should be occupied by footer. Okay, so this is how I'll define the grid template. So this is my template. I'm saying on the top row there are three columns, and in each column I need to see header. And in this, there are three columns, and in one column, menu is there, main is there, and right is there. And then in the below one, this menu is occupying two rows basically. So I'm repeating this menu here, and the rest of the two columns are occupied by footer. Okay, so this template I'll define first. Okay, so these three rows and these three columns we have defined now. So the second thing we need to do is define these grid items. Okay, so for example, I need to define the header item, header class. Okay, so how do I define this is I have a property called grid area. Okay, so how I need to define the grid area is I just need to say these area names. Like I have defined the first row as header, right? So this is the area name. It is called as header. Okay, and this area name is called as menu, and this area name is called as main. This area is right, and similarly, this area is called as footer. Okay, so now I'm saying header should occupy this header area in this template, grid template. Okay, so then what I need to do is I need to define the next one, which is menu. Okay, so I'll say menu, then grid area, and this should occupy the menu area in my template. So I'll say menu, right? So then it occupies the menu part, and I will define the main one similarly. I need to define main, right, and footer, right? So I'm just copy pasting it. So I need to define main here. Sorry, I need to define main here, and this will occupy the main area, and here it is right. Right now I am defining the right area, so this is right, and then I need to do the footer area here, right, and this is the footer. Okay, so I have defined all these things. So but all this is not coming proper. Okay, so what we are missing is we need to give these inverted colons. So let me give these inverted colons, then you will see it right. Okay, so now you should see it right. Okay, so now if we add the borders, right, then we should see it in a proper way. So border 1 pixel solid black, if I do, so if I give this on all the items, okay, so if I just copy paste this onto all the divs, right, so you need to see the right picture which we are aiming at. Okay, so this is what we wanted to happen, and this has happened. Okay, so this is how you create the layouts using one way of this grid container. So we have seen the flexbox way of doing it, and we have also seen the other way, which is the grid templates. And there is a third way of doing it also. Okay, so that's using the property called grid column start. Okay, so let me delete the grid template here. Okay, so then you will have this this layout. So I need to delete the grid area also. Okay, so I will delete this too. So I've deleted everything. So the thought process in this would be just as we think in Excel. Like for example, this header, right? The start of this header, it has started at the first column, and it will span up to third column, right? So I'll just merge it like this. So I'll just span it and merge it. So that's what we'll say here, right? So I'll say grid column start is at 1. It has to start at first column. Okay, so the grid start, grid column start would be at 1. And if you see the grid column end, right, it will be like number of the columns totally available plus 1, which would be 4. Like the it is a 3 column layout, right? So totally there are 3 columns, but it would end at the 4th column starting. So the so that's why we are giving 4 columns here. Okay, similarly, we will start the row of the menu. This is the row, right? And it will start at 2, and it will end at 4, because it is a 3 row layout. So the row end would be at 4. Okay, at the start of the 4th column, basically, which doesn't exist, but we need to specify like that. Okay, so then if you take main, right, main and right are properly aligned. We need to bother only about footer now. So let us copy the column. So column start for the footer. Okay, now footer's column starts at 2, and it spans until 4. It ends at the column 4. Right. So this is how you can achieve this layout, just as we do it in Excel. So this has started at 1. And it has ended at start of the 4th cell, and this has started at 2, and it has ended at the start of the 4th cell, because total there are 3 rows. It has ended at the start of the 4th row. That's how you mention. Okay, and these two are aligned without doing anything. Okay, and the 4th footer, this has started the 2nd column, and it has ended at the start of the 4th column. Okay, so that's how you specify, and you can align to. Okay, so these are the 3 ways of aligning items using grids. Hope you have got a good understanding. And how to align, center align, vertical align using grids, that you can refer to W3 schools. Okay, so this is just an introduction as to how you think. Okay, thank you.